Kansas City barbecue or Texas barbecue?
Come on, Kansas City.
Oh, traitor.
Nothing beats Texas barbecue.
It's far superior to anything in Kansas City.
Yeah, if you're talking brisket, there's no place other than Texas. I don't care what kind of barbecue they're cooking up there.
Mendon Hale with us in Bandwagon TV's Joyride all the way from Missouri. We got Sumner, Missouri here. I cannot wait. This is the first time, and I wanted to say Missouri, so that's why I'm really looking forward to this interview.
You know what? You can tell if someone's really from Missouri if they say Missouri. That's yep. How you can tell.
That's great, and that's why I wanted to say it. I wanted to be a local. Here we are. We're driving in Sumner, like you just said. 100 people in Sumner, Missouri. Mendon, if you can, tell us a little bit about your music, your musical influences, a little bit about your background and how you got into country music.
Well, let's see. So I've always been a huge fan of Alabama. Was one of the first bands that I really loved, and my mom was a big influence with like Johnny Cash and Elvis. And then my dad had like the rock and roll stuff, like Boston and Cheap Trick and REO Speedwagon, and I think it's just kind of the big mishmash there of good music, I think. And let's see, growing up as a kid, I listened to the AM radio with my grandpa and my uncle, and listening to all they had was like the classic country station. So that was pretty much all we did. And then my brother, you know, grew up and did the 80s music, and yeah, it all kind of like jammed in from there.
You're an 80s kid. I mean, so when we do a lot of research, you know, we're looking up, we want to find some unique, every musician is different, but something unique to you. And behind, I don't know if we can see it, but I noticed from some of your videos, you got the whole starting lineup. As a kid, that's what I grew up on those action figures. You're an 80s kid. Talk about like just the things that just are particular, things that you like about the 80s.
Oh man, I tell you, we used to three-wheelers. I don't know if a lot of people remember three-wheelers.
Since Honda invented the three-wheel all-terrain cycle, people have found it real handy for lots of chores because it handles the rough country.
Because now they have like quads.
Uh-huh.
Quads are cool, but I tell you what, if you've ever ridden a three-wheeler, you were nuts, man, because those were just made so poorly, they were bound to like tip over. So, you know, it's kind of like Daredevil, you know, if you drove one of those. I think I started driving, I started driving, tractor whenever. That's when, I was like, 8 or 9 years old. My grandpa's like, hey, put your foot on the clutch here. And don't move. And he's like changing, you know, something underneath the big tractor, like the huge, 40-20 tractor. I don't want to, crush the guy. But, you start doing it at an early age, and the three-wheelers, oh, man, just danger. I guess that's the way it is, danger.
Well, and that's
danger.
I think that's why they got rid of those. They got rid of those three-wheelers.
Now, those are seriously dangerous. Seriously dangerous.
I think
but we had a lot of fun.
That's awesome. And now, Sumner is like, in the country, if you can't just tell us a little bit about the music scene, the country scene in Missouri, Missouri.
Well, you know what? Kansas City has a good scene. I like St. Joe, where I grew up. Main focus is going to be, throughout the rest of the Midwest, is all, and also down to Texas, too. But the scene in Missouri, Kansas City is, like I said, Kansas City is always fun down the plaza there. And even over in St. Louis, the blues, we got all that. But anytime you got Columbia, Missouri down, that's where the University of Missouri is, that's always a fun time.
All right. Mendon, fantastic. I appreciate everything you just said. And again, we're excited to have you on, but we got to pull over the white lightning because we want to get into the lightning round. Are you ready, my friend?
Yeah, I was getting kind of car sick.
And the white lightning zips.
An animal back there. I'm not sure what happened.
That's that roadkill. All right, we're pulling over. We're going to get into the lightning round, but I got to ask you, sir, with Bandwagon TVs, we've been really promoting local businesses. Like I say, it goes kind of hand in hand with a lot of independent musicians. Sir, do you got a local business that you want to promote with us today?
I do. Out
great.
Of Sumner, Cooney's General Store right here.
And
they got pretty much everything, and they just got new gas pumps. So, and they got hats now, too.
And new gas pumps. I mean, that's the exciting news in town.
It was.
For us, we're promoting a local barbecue place, barbecue shop called Young's Barbecue and More. And they're fantastic. So you do come back to Texas. We'd love to show you around and give you really the Texas treat. They're known for their barbecue burrito.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I tell you what, I'm a big fan of barbecue. And Kansas City is where it is. So it's gotta be pretty good barbecue for me.
Kansas City is good. I'm not gonna lie. I went there with my sister and there's a well-known spot. It's like an old gas station too. And I can't remember now offhand what it's called, but we loaded up on Kansas barbecue there. That sauce is a little bit different.
Right.
Awesome. Mendenhall, here we go. We're going into the lightning round. You've already mentioned your local business. And this is where you enter with the hard-hitting questions. So we need some answers. I gotta ask you, my friend, I'm getting already excited with this. A hot cup of coffee or an ice-cold beer? What do you got?
Oh, ice-cold beer every time.
There you go. And so, Sumner, I saw, you know, you're on the lake, and maybe this is the video. Do you go out on the lake a lot? I mean, are you, in terms of the town, what do you do out for fun, other than drink lots of beer?
There's a spoiler alert. That was filmed in Nebraska, so.
Oh!
I know. So it wasn't the hometown. And I never had the pontoon boat, either. Like, we had, like, the small John boats, and so, like, the small fishing boats. So I would go out on the lake a little bit, but our lakes were a lot different than the... than that lake. You know, our lakes got mud.
Okay. So you've had a great year. I mean, and that's one of the reasons I got very excited when we started talking and chatting on Instagram to have you on. You've been a very busy man, so I want you to plug here after this what you got. But keeping with your theme of 2021, singles like Cheap and All the Way to the Bank, I have to ask, if you had an infinite amount of money, what's the first thing you'd buy?
That's a great question. I would probably buy something to clone my dog, Sophie Jo, because she is the best dog ever. I don't know how much that would cost, but that's what I would try to do.
Like Benji the dog. What's your dog's name again? Sophie?
Sophie Jo.
Sophie Jo, she is on your page. What is she? Is she a doodle mix?
No. Here's another thing, too. We had to use... Huckleberry was the Labradoodle in the video. So that was my video guy, Simon Clark, his parents' dog, I think it was, but he did a great job. My dog, it was too hot for her. She's 9 and, you know, we didn't think it would be good for her to be out all day, and we filmed out, you know, out all day, but that was little Huckleberry. Yeah, that was Huckleberry. He's a Labradoodle. My dog's a German Shepherd.
Oh.
And I'm pulling over here, she's over here.
Oh, God.
Great.
Now we're driving. You're actually, you've taken the wheel of the White Lightning. I have to ask, you need a co-pilot. You're driving coast to coast, dead or alive. Who do you got as your co-pilot, musician?
David Lee Roth.
That'd be a blast.
Can you imagine the stories that he could tell?
Oh, yeah. You know, we've had a lot of Sammy Hagar, so I'm glad, you know, you're evening the field here with Van Halen. We needed some David Lee Roth. I mean, come on. Look at that. The fun. The amount of fun.
I'm a huge Van Halen fan. It's one of the things, like, you know, when I was a kid, like, my dad would, you know, and a lot of people don't know, but Gary Richrath was the guitarist of the band REO Speedwagon. I don't think anyone knows him, but he passed away recently. But I was a huge Gary Richrath fan. And then Eddie Van Halen, I started listening to a lot of Eddie Van Halen, and so that's why I'm a huge Van Halen fan. And it just kind of took over my life.
Well, you're not making it to your destination. I'm going to tell you that right now. You got a cooler ice cold beer in the back. I doubt it. Now David Lee Roth is he's in the passenger seat. He's going through your phone, looking through a playlist. Is there a song, maybe a band, that would surprise us, maybe even, you know, embarrass you?
Let me check here. For some reason, I don't know why, but I had a whole album of like 1930s hits.
Okay.
And it's good big band music, and I don't I'm not a big fan of big band stuff. I just haven't. And so I guess that's easy listening, I suppose.
Yeah, that would surprise us.
I surprised myself.
There you go. Yeah, that surprised all of us.
It ties into David Lee Roth, I guess.
It does. Ties it all the loose ends together. All right, I appreciate. Fantastic. You flew through the White Lightning. Now, this is on you. You have lots of things coming up. 2021.
Yes.
I want you to tell us everything. You got two new singles. Now you have a new EP. Tell us all about that.
Okay. So, yeah, a new EP comes out on July 23rd. And then, let's see, we're going to be starting to go back on the road. I know we're going to be starting from Nashville and going through Texas and the Midwest a little bit. And that's going to be September. And what comes after September? October. Yeah, so probably in the fall. In the fall, there's going to be a lot of shows, and we're going to go out on the road. We're going to have another video for the single, which is actually Hand on the Heartland. Mm-hmm. It's the title track, and we're going to have a big video for that, which we're really excited about because it's really cool.
I want to get into this really quick because you just mentioned video. Yeah. Great segue. You have one. I think your music is fun. You know, I always say, you know, fun music, you want to be on the boat, on the lake, or doing something outside. Your videos are fantastic. Do you have like a team that you continue to use?
I'm using a marketing team out in a digital team in Nashville who hooked me up with this guy, Simon Clark, and his team. And they're here in Omaha, Nebraska. I tell you, like any video you do, it's got to be fun. You know, and they're so good at what they do and bringing things to life and in the you know, the way they film it and whatever they do. We always have a good time because I always bring a cooler beer. If you notice in the especially Cheap and All the Way to the Bank video, there's a red cooler full of beer. We sat and drank those beers.
Great. All right, so this is on you. How do we follow you? How do we listen to you?
Well, you can go to anywhere. You can go to bendandhale.com. You can go to Instagram. You can go to Spotify, Facebook, all the socials that you can. It's all on Spotify, iTunes, YouTube. We're trying to get more subscribers on that. And then let's see. Yeah, it's all on the website, bendandhale.com.
Yeah, you got a great website. And, you know, you just said YouTube. Subscribe, it's so important. You know, give these musicians a little bit of a follow. They all need it. But you got great content, so you're never going to be bored following Men in Hail. So,
true.
Men in, we've hit the end of the road in Sumner. I got to kick you out. This has been a lot of fun, and I got all your beer here, and I want to drink it all. Before we kick you out, all we need is a song. Can you play us a song before we let you go?
I can do this, yes.
All right, what song are you playing for us today?
I think I'm going to sing the song called Gravel Roads, which is the CD, the title track of the CD that was released back in 2020. So long ago.
I love it. Classic. All right. Well, hey, go ahead whenever you're ready.
I'm going crazy, man. I might be out of my mind. This concrete jungle feels like I've been doing time. And I just don't fit into your busy city life. Cause what I need's a front row seat on a back porch swing tonight. So won't you take me back home where the world is paved with them gravel roads. Drive me to my memories, take me right back home. Called the Sportsman Inn, where everyone you're drinking with becomes your new best friend. And just past those railroad tracks, that old farm on the right, is where I spend all of my time, right by my grandpa's side. So won't you take me back home, where the world is paved with them gravel roads. Drive me to my memories, take me right back home. my memories take you right back home, where I always want to be. And I don't need your city streets when I got dirt under my feet. So while you hurry up and go, I'll sit back and take it slow. So won't you take me back home, where the world is paved with them gravel roads.
Go, that's Men in Hail with a classic. Love it. You got a lot going on, so I can't wait to start plugging. You got some fantastic content. I appreciate your time, sir.
Well, thank you very much, and I want to thank everyone that watched and liked and everything too. So thank you very much. I hope to see you on the road soon.
Yeah, thank you, and we'll hopefully see you in Texas.
Absolutely.
All right, go Tigers.
Take a picture, love, 'cause this could be our lucky day.